Good morning, everyone. It's a wonderful day at Illinois today. We're all thrilled to be here. I'm excited that you're all here and sharing this great event with us. I'm delighted to introduce to you today our new athletic director, Josh Whitman. Josh will be the 14th permanent athletic director at Illinois, and I am so excited that he's here and want to share a little information with you before we let him speak. I want to thank everyone for the passion and enthusiasm that you've expressed during this process. Lots of questions, lots of emails, lots of attempts to get at this story sooner rather than later. Some of your information hasn't been quite right, but we didn't scold you along the way because I always interpret it as your enthusiasm about Illinois. So I'm just delighted to finally be at this point. We've had a wonderful search process. There are several members of our search committee here in the room, and I want to acknowledge them. Matt Wheeler over here, who chaired our search, could not have done this without Matt, an incredible leader in athletics and a professor of animal sciences here on our campus. I know there are several other members. Howard Milton here? There he is right there. Judge Flannel over here. I don't know who else is here. Our wonderful coach, Janice back there. So we had wonderful representation on the search committee. The search committee worked very hard with me. Some of you felt it was a long process, and I can tell you that for academic and athletic searches, I felt like we moved about as quickly as we could. We got started in November. We had some bumps along the way with procurement, but once we found a great search firm, we moved pretty quickly. We did have a holiday break in there, so we did let people go on holiday break and didn't work during that time. But we did a very thorough process that involved a lot of consultation with stakeholders, identifying the criteria that we felt were most important for this position, and it's a long list of criteria. When I met with the coaches and we discussed this before the search really started, one of them said, "So you're looking for someone who walks on water?" And I said, "Yeah, we are, basically." And we found him. The search committee was, I'm not looking at Josh right now. The search committee was enormously helpful. We vetted many candidates. We met in places that some of you speculated about. We did a very thorough process of vetting a lot of people who were interested in this position. We had well over 50 nominations and candidates to look at. So we feel extraordinarily grateful that we attracted this great person. So just a minute. I'd also like to thank Paul Kowalczyk, who's in the audience here, our interim director for athletics. Could not have managed the last few months without Paul. He's an enormous leader here, and he's provided a tremendous amount of stability in DIA. So thank you, Paul. I'm indebted to you and to all you've done. Also want to take a moment to thank the search firm. We used Korn Ferry, and some people wonder about search firms. I'm here to say, and no one paid me to say this, Korn Ferry did an absolutely exceptional job helping us along the way. They stayed at a distance when we needed them to. They got involved closely when we needed them. Big shout out to Chad Chatlos, who was really our key person at Korn Ferry. Again, they didn't pay me to say that. I'm just telling you, we had a great experience with the search firm. So a few minutes, I'll just give my feelings about Josh and what I think of him, and then of course I know you're all really here to hear from him, not to hear me dribble on here. But Josh is really the full package. As we were thinking about who we wanted to be the next AD, we were looking for someone with integrity, someone who cared deeply about the welfare of student athletes, someone who was devoted to diversity issues, someone who really understands academic excellence and how academic excellence can go hand in hand with athletic excellence. And we wanted somebody who had a lot of experience in the world of college athletics, because it's a complex world. I'm learning a lot about it. It requires stability, integrity, and somebody with a great kind of personal charisma, if you will. And add to all of that, it's great to have an Illini. That wasn't a criterion from the beginning, but it was what I call icing on the cake. If we could get all of the things we needed, plus someone who loved Illinois, that would be the best of all possible worlds. And we've certainly found that with Josh. And so without further ado, I think that I'll just turn the mic over to Josh and let you hear from him. Thank you.
My thanks to Barb. This process has been remarkable from the beginning, and I've certainly enjoyed getting to know Barb, and I've told anybody who would listen that my first order of duty, and everybody wants to say, what are you going to do first? Well, my first thing is I'm going to try and convince Barb that she should stay in the chancellorship, and so we're going to work on that starting today. But she has just been an incredible leader for the university during a very difficult time. Respect her immensely for the tremendous leadership that she has given us, and look forward to working with her in the years to come. Also, a lot of thank yous, as you can imagine. I want to thank President Colleen, the Board of Trustees, including the Chair, Ed McMillan. I want to recognize Matt Wheeler, Search Committee Chair. Matt and I have known each other for a long, long time, and look forward to working with him and his faculty athletics role for the years to come. And the search committee enjoyed, you know, I was saying last night to some people, this search process. Thank you, Matt.
I haven't seen the blue, John.
Orange and blue. Look at this.
Nice.
Thank you, Trent. Hey. Wow, I wasn't expecting that. It's unbelievable to see these jerseys, to see the colors. But you know, as I was saying to someone last night, these search processes are very unusual, right? You walk into this big room at a hotel, you sit at the end of this long conference table. It feels like you're on a movie set, and there's all these people staring at you, and you go around the room and you answer questions, and then you get up and you leave. And you know, there's no feedback. Hey, that was a great answer. Or, oh, you really stunk it up on that one. And so you don't really know until far after the fact really how it went. But enjoyed that process very much. And thanks to the search committee for their great work. Also want to recognize Paul Kowalczyk. It has been a difficult few months. I understand that. And he has stepped in and just done a wonderful job leading the program during this interim period, and Jason Leonard standing with him as well, and the two of them at the head of our department have really done fantastic work. And so thanks to them, the other senior leaders in the department. I know that it has been a challenging few months, and look forward to visiting with you and understanding those challenges and helping us forge ahead. A few personal thanks. I want to begin with my wonderful wife, Hope. My family is sitting over here, standing along the wall. Hope is just a remarkable person. I'm excited for the Champaign community not to get really me, but to get her. I think she's a far better get, if you will, for the Champaign-Urbana community. Just a really wonderful person. I just met with the staff a minute ago and thought that this group might enjoy this story as well. And one of our very first date was to the Bragging Rights game. We went and watched Illinois beat Mizzou a year ago. We've moved quickly. And shortly after that, I convinced her to come here with me to Champaign. And we had not been dating very long, but I thought it was important that she see this place that has meant so much to me. And we came, we took selfies in front of the alma mater, we snuck into the stadium. And it was a very enjoyable couple days, and I think it gave her a taste for just how important this place is to me, just how impactful this university and this athletic program have been in my life. And here we are a year more or more later, and we're coming home, and it feels great, and I'm just so blessed to have a partner like her who is supportive of what we're doing, and just excited about the life that awaits us here. I also want to recognize my parents. I don't know if you all realize this, but you don't get a lot of choice with who your parents are going to be. And I won the lottery. I've got my folks over here, Mark and Mary Beth Whitman. They've watched as many games in that stadium across the street as I've played, as well as every other stadium around the country. They never missed a game. And I think it was just unbelievably supportive for me to know, no matter the outcome, no matter the performance, that those two folks were going to be up in the stands. And I remember very distinctly after my junior year, we won at Michigan. We came back from being down 27-7 in the third quarter, beat Tom Brady and the Wolverines. And they were good, you know, and dad, the team kind of ran over to the wall, and we were hugging family members, and my dad reached down and hugged me. He said, "You just beat Michigan in the Big House." And it was just so special to me to be able to share that experience with him. And so I'm grateful to both of them for being here on this very special day. Also want to recognize Van Curtis. Van's the guy with the cell phone and the funky tie against the wall. He's a family friend of ours. He grew up with my dad. He's really been like a second father to me my entire life, and he'll be along for this ride. So for those of you in the room who are going to be around a lot, I apologize in advance. You'll understand why later. Coaches have been an unbelievable influence on me. You'll get to know me over time, and you'll understand that the relationships that we form with our coaches, with our student athletes, to me, that's the foundational piece of a successful athletic program. And I've had so many unbelievable coaches in my life, people who have made these indelible imprints on who I am. Certainly the coaches here were no exception. Coach Turner, Coach Greg McMahon, Coach Tim Kish, Harry Heestand, Leslie Frazier. These were all people who were instrumental in bringing me here and who were a part of my daily life and really set a tremendous example for me. And going back even before I got to Illinois, Jeff Van Arsdale was my head basketball coach in high school, and A.J. Rickard was my football coach, and those two guys continue to be tremendous mentors and friends to me. And those are the kinds of relationships that we want our coaches to form with our athletes here, these life-changing relationships. And certainly those people for me have been that. It is unbelievable to look around the room today and see so many familiar faces. I see in the back, Ron Gunther is sitting there. Ron is the reason that I became an athletic director. When I first started understanding that this position even existed, I went and met with Ron and got a better sense of who he is and what he does, and that was what inspired me to get into this profession in the first place. He's remained a tremendous mentor, and I'm grateful to him for his assistance. Larry DeBrock is in the room, Matt Wheeler. I hesitate to name too many people just because I could literally go around and almost point at every person standing here. Please just know that if you are here and we have shared something in our past, that I look forward very much to continuing to building on those relationships and using the great power that we have here to advance the efforts of our institution, our athletic program. Lastly, I want to thank my teammates. As you can all appreciate, this thing that we do here is pretty intense. It's a lot of time, it's a lot of effort, and the people that you do it with truly become your family. And I think that's something that separates athletics from just about any other endeavor in life. And it's just been so humbling these last few hours, days, the outpouring of support that I have received from my former teammates, people who I sweat with and bled with, the text messages, the phone calls, the emails. It's really been a powerful moment for me, and I'm excited to represent them as we go forward. Pat Rouse is here. Pat was a great teammate of mine back when we were here, and it's just an unbelievable responsibility and one that I take very, very seriously. Before I get too far into my comments, I want to take a moment and talk about Washington University. That's where I've been for the last year and a half. It's an incredible institution. It is full of remarkable people. I feel so privileged to have had the opportunity to be the athletic director there, and I know that a lot of people maybe aren't familiar with WashU, and if you're not, I would encourage you to become so. It is one of the world's great institutions, and we're very fortunate there in St. Louis to have one of the world's finest Division III athletic programs. We compete on a national level, and we recruit our students from around the country to come and receive an experience that's unparalleled in terms of the athletic and academic excellence that they're able to achieve. And so I want to thank the administration in St. Louis. I want to thank our coaches, our staff, our student athletes. They've inspired me every day, and I am very grateful to them for that. It's funny, I've lived this moment in my mind probably a million times. Ever since I was a freshman, sophomore in college, this is what I've wanted to do. And everything I've done since then, when I was as an undergraduate and since I left the university, has been with an eye toward preparing myself for this moment. And there were times in law school, and one of my law professors, Lawyer Reynolds, is here. There were times in law school when I wondered if it was worth it. I'm not going to lie. But I had to believe that the plan would work and that the preparation would pay off. And I never knew when or even if this opportunity would present itself, but I knew that when it did, if it did, I wanted to be ready. And I'm so happy and thrilled to be here, humbled to be here. This is a dream for me. This is an opportunity for me to take the last job that I hope I ever have. That's the kind of power that this place has for me. It's the kind of opportunity that this place presents. And I could not be more excited about what we're about to do. It's that pride that I think resonates most with me, and I hope with the other people in the room. I had a chance to meet with our staff across the way in Oven before the press conference this morning, and I told a story about the first time I ever came to campus. And my folks and I were in a car. It was the summer after my junior year, and we were driving down Florida just here behind us. And as you're driving west, you get to the end there by the cemetery, and all of a sudden the trees fall away, and for the first time you see the stadium. And I just remember catching my breath because I couldn't believe how magnificent and big and powerful that building was, and I couldn't believe that I had the opportunity to go in there and compete for our fans and our students and our donors and our alumni every single Saturday. And my challenge to the staff, and what happened a little bit over time as I was here for those 4 years, was you start to take a little bit for granted. You go out to practice and you forget about the magnificence that's behind you. You go out and you know, you got your dauber down, you got to go out and practice. It's cold, it's wet, it's whatever. My challenge to our staff, to our student athletes, to everybody involved in the Illini Nation is let's not ever take this for granted. Let's not ever take for granted the opportunity that we have to be affiliated with one of the great universities in the world, to be a part of an athletic program that is befitting of that university. This is a special, special place. You know, it's funny, I asked them, this is my helmet. I've had it in every office that I've ever had. And I asked them to put it in here, and some of this stuff, and some of that paint, I didn't put that on there with a brush. You know, there's a lot of work and a lot of pride that comes with this opportunity for me. And I don't ever want anybody to lose sight of that. I understand the awesomeness of this responsibility. I am humbled by it, and I'm so looking forward to taking time to get to know each and every person on our staff, spending time with our students. I am so thrilled about our student athletes. It's something that I look forward to every day in my current position, is the chance to interact with our student athletes. I want to have that relationship. It's important to me. I want them to know who I am, that I care about them, that I admire what they do, what they represent. People ask me a lot about a vision. And I can tell you, I think we have three broad goals for our athletic program. First and foremost, and again, reflecting on my own experience, we want to change the lives of our student athletes. We want to put their needs first and foremost. Everything we do, every decision we make, will be informed by what is in the best interest of our students. The reason we're here is them. We're here to teach them. We are here to grow them. We are here to prepare them for their lives after they leave our campus. That will be at the forefront of every decision we make and every day that we live here. Second goal, we will inspire and impassion the Illini Nation. We have an incredible group of people who care about this place, about our athletic program. It is a tremendous opportunity for all of us to become involved in supporting this great opportunity that we have here. Our job is to rally that support, to give them something to be proud of, to continue to tell the good stories about the wonderful things that are happening here. It's very common in today's media to focus on the negative, to talk about the things that are the shortcomings in college athletics, and certainly we have some. But far too often we lose sight of the wonderful things that are happening in college athletics, the difference that we're making in our worlds of our student athletes. People are getting educations because of our program. People are preparing themselves to go off and be leaders in their communities, loving members of their families, successful members of their professions because of our program. We want to rally that support. We want people to take great pride in the orange and blue, and we will do everything we can to generate that. I look forward to getting around the state, getting around the country, shaking a lot of hands, talking to a lot of people, listening to what people's concerns are, and developing a program that we can all be proud of. And the last thing, and I know some of you probably saw the letter that I sent out yesterday, we will win. It's important. That's what everybody's thirsty for. We don't get in this to come in second place. That's not our purpose. We understand that this is competitive, big-time college athletics. Our student-athletes are the best in the country. We will surround them with the resources that they need, with the mentors, the teachers, the coaches that they need to enjoy every bit of their possibility. We want them to expand their realm. We want them to become better than they ever imagined they could be. But we will win. It will take a lot of time. This is not an overnight fix, but it starts today. It starts today. And the last thing I'll say, and then stop and take a drink of water here. The last thing I'll say is that we need everybody. This is a movement. We need a coalition of people, and the bigger that coalition becomes, the bigger the Illini Nation grows, the more passionate we become, the better we can be. This is not about Josh Whitman. It's not about Barb Wilson. We are parts of what we hope becomes an incredibly successful puzzle. But in order for us to realize that vision, in order for us to realize that dream, we need every Illini everywhere to get involved. We need them to support us. We want to bring renewed optimism and hope and energy to our fan base. I know it's easy sometimes to cast aspersions. It's easy to get down. We have to fight. We have to fight that. Because the opportunity is in front of us. We have unbelievable potential here. Unbelievable, untapped potential. We have a lot of fantastic, fantastic people in this building and in the other buildings around campus. We have a remarkable group of student athletes. If we unify, if we unite ourselves, we can be the best. If I didn't believe that, I wouldn't be here. I am unbelievably humbled and honored by this responsibility. On behalf of Hope, my folks, my family, and myself, we are thrilled. We are thrilled to be back home and thrilled to be back with our Illini. Thank you.
Josh, Jeremy Warner, Scott.com. Welcome back.
Thank you. You
talked about unifying. Do you see that as a huge issue? What do you think those issues are?
I think it's important that as we go forward, we give everybody something to be excited about. You know, it's an opportunity that we all have. We all share responsibility in this and trying to bring people together. Because it's like anything else. What's the saying? If you chase two rabbits, both of them will escape. You know, if we are not able to all pull the rope in the same direction, we're not getting the job done that we all want so badly to be done. And so I think it is. It's critical that we all get in line, that we all understand the vision that's in front of us, and we all start to row the boat because we want to get there.
Hey, Josh. Peter Billy Wells, Daily Illini. Welcome to campus. Especially in terms of students, what kind of things, do you have any specific goals, at least right off the bat, of making athletic events something for students to go to, especially on the weekends when it's easy to go downtown?
I don't remember that. You know, absolutely. We want, our program should be something that enhances the experience of every undergraduate student on our campus. We want it to be that source of pride. We want our student athletes to walk around with their letter jackets on, proud of what they're doing. We want the students to enjoy being around them. We want to give them something to unify behind. And at the end of the day, we recognize that the thing that's going to electrify people more than anything is success. People want to support a winner, and our job is to put that together. But certainly, we will do everything we can to outreach to our students. I think we have tremendous student involvement here. The Orange Crush is something that's been going for a long time, unlike any other student body organization in the country. So proud of that group and the social difference that they make. The Block I history, of course, is so significant. And so I think we need to look for opportunities to capitalize on those legacies and continue to make inroads with our student population. Like I said, make this an integral part of their experience as a student at Illinois.
Josh, football and basketball obviously haven't been living up to, I think, anybody's standards here. A lot of people want to know about the future, the status of the current coaches, all of that, the support that you'll have for them.
I think that Coach Gross, Coach Cubitt, both of whom are in the room, appreciate their support. I had a chance to visit with them just briefly this morning. Really looking forward to having a chance to sit down and meet them, talk with them in more depth. I think they're tremendous coaches. I am so excited to work with them and figure out ways that I can surround them with resources and opportunity to put our programs in better positions to be successful. So, gentlemen, I appreciate you being here. Look forward to two of those conversations.
Shannon Ryan, Chicago Tribune. Congratulations. Coming from Division III, when you were in the interviews, what were some of the experiences you pointed to show that this would, that, you know, it would translate well and your transition would be smooth? And maybe if Chancellor Wilson could answer that too.
Well, for me, building a championship culture is not something that's labeled with a Division III or a Division I. You want to surround yourself with people who share a vision, who bring an energy to their daily work. I think so often it's about the people. You know, people want to say, well, it's a bigger budget, and oh, there's these different pressures, and oh, there's this media attention. That's all true. But at the end of the day, it's about acting and performing to a standard of excellence. And we've been able to do that both at WashU and UW La Crosse, the institution I was at previous to that. And although you may have a few more people on the staff, although you may have a few more zeros on the balance sheet, that I think stays very consistent from one program to the next, and excited to capitalize on those experiences here.
I'd like to add a few things to that. You know, we really were looking for someone who had experience across the board in all facets of this complex job, someone who understood the student athlete experience, someone who had great fundraising experience, someone who had made tough decisions, someone who had hired coaches, someone who could get up in front of the media and actually do a great job of articulating what it is we're all about, somebody who understands the twin coupling of academics with athletics. We are a powerhouse institution on the academic side, and we need to ensure that the athletic side is right there with us. So those were some of the criteria for me, but honestly, you know, I interviewed all of the finalists, and I won't give you a number, even though you might like to know that, but I can tell you that during my interview with Josh, and I told him later, I didn't take any notes. I was just sitting there listening to him and realizing as I heard his answers to my questions that I was looking at the next athletic director right there. So he just is an impressive person, and I hope you can all see that today.
Hi, Josh. Matt with WAND TV.
Hey, Matt.
I know a lot of former players over the last really 6 months have kind of weighed in on the state of things to varying degrees. I'm curious what your thoughts about Illinois were before you got offered this job. I'm sure you were watching from afar. Curious what you thought about the program and maybe what needed to be done here.
I think looking at it 3 months ago, 4 months ago, like you said, before the process started, I was like most people. I recognized that there were some challenges. Certainly, we've had some situations that haven't cast us in the best light. We all recognize that. And I more than anything, and I know this is what my fellow alumni, my teammates, what we all share, is we recognize that some of these situations have cast our university, our athletic program, in a light that doesn't represent what we really are. And that, I think, is the biggest source of both frustration and hope for me, is that as we move forward, we have an opportunity to better represent who we are and what we're about. And I know that in talking with, like I said, with the other alums, that's something that was a concern, is that it wasn't representative of what this place is about. And we're excited now to be sure that we're acting in accordance with those expectations and living up to those standards.
Hi, Josh. Brett Behrens, WCIA-TV.
Hi.
Welcome back. What type of leader will you be with your coaches, with your direct senior associates below you, and will you move quickly on some of your decisions you'll have to make here?
You know, leadership is something to me that is the beginning and ending of what I do. This position is all about leadership. It's something that I take very seriously. It's something I enjoy very much. I study it. I read about it. And for me, at the end of the day, being an effective leader really comes down to one thing, and people who have worked with me in the past know what it is. It's trust. And you have to develop trust with the people around you. And that takes time. You have to develop relationships. They have to understand that you are concerned about them, that you care about them. And I think at the end of the day, there are two sides to what I call the leadership coin. The first side is empowerment. You want to give people responsibility. You want to encourage them to do good work in roles that play to their strengths. I think a lot of leaders are pretty good at the empowerment piece. The thing that I think separates truly average leaders from exceptional leaders is the opposite side of that coin, which is accountability. And it takes a special person to lay the groundwork, to develop the relationships, and to deliver a somewhat critical message in a productive and constructive way, so that at the end of that meeting, the person that you're talking to feels good about what you just told them. They understand that this is about us getting better. It's not about someone trying to beat someone down and say, you know, you did this bad. It's about how can we do this better so that we all are better going forward. And I think that you have to be prepared to have those conversations. I don't shy away from difficult conversations. I think that honesty and directness are important. But you have to lay the groundwork with people. You have to let them know that you trust them, that you care about them. And you have to deliver the message in such a way that they understand that it's not an attack at them, but it's an effort to be better.
Congratulations. I'm David Mercer from AP.
I do.
Hi. To what extent are you comfortable with the idea that you don't know who your boss is going to be yet?
Well, no, it's a fair question.
No offense taken.
I've already told you my feelings about Barb and my hope that she will stay on in her position as chancellor. But I would be lying if I didn't say that certainly that was some consideration as you were evaluating the opportunity. Everybody wants to know who their boss is going to be. Everybody wants to know that there's going to be stability and support. And you know, I got into this process very curious to see how I would feel. And after meeting with Barb, and we had a chance to talk at length on a number of different topics, but as I talked with Barb, we addressed that issue in particular. And she was very, very supportive, understanding. She assured me that the university is committed to this athletic program, is committed to us fielding the kind of teams that we all want us to see. And then I think following that meeting, it was important that I have a chance to meet with our president, our board chair. They were good enough to have a meeting with me on Monday. And again, to reiterate that commitment from the institution that no matter who ultimately might sit in this chair that Barb is in right now, there will be that support from the university for our athletic program. And that meant a great deal to me and gave me peace with the decision.
Josh, Mark Tupper from Decatur. Nice to see you. Congratulations.
Nice to see you. Thank you.
It sounds like this next month is going to be really crazy for you. I know you want to disconnect at Washington in a proper way. And so will you be back and forth and back and forth? Is that kind of how it's going to go here for a little bit?
It will be, yeah. I'll be up here for a few days, back in St. Louis for a few days. My last day right now is tentatively scheduled at WashU to be March 4th. And then I will, hoping I will start to transition up here. My first day in the office full-time, sort of without any turning back, will be March 21st. But between now and then, I'll be at some basketball games. I'll have a chance to go up to the Big Ten meetings next week. I'll be at the Big Ten tournament. So I'll be making some appearances and trying to get up to speed the best I can during these interim weeks until I'm here and able to hit the ground running.
Hi, Josh. My name is Rob McCauley, and like you, I have a JD that I'm not really using from the College of Law. But I know that the legal education can inform everything that you do in life. And so as a background, I'm kind of you mentioned Lori Reynolds. I'd like to know, who did you have for contracts, torts, property, crim law, crim pro, con law, and civ pro? And did you get any Bs?
That's a long question. Well, I had Professor Reynolds, who was here in the room for property. Thought I bombed her test. Boy, that was rough. Had Professor Andy Leopold for criminal law, criminal procedure. Had Charles Tabb for contracts. Had Professor Nowak for con law. Civ Pro, I had, gosh, his last name started with an R. I can't remember. Maybe. I can't remember. But did I get a B? I'm sure I did. I'm sure I did, yes.
Josh, I talked with Ron Turner yesterday. He said you did get one B.
Good that he's keeping track.
Obviously, there's a lot of work to do here. But, you know, this business, especially at this level, people want a quick turnaround. What do you tell Illini fans about what you can do to show them progress early and how long this process will take?
You know, it's funny. Although it's a different world in some respects, the situation here isn't altogether different than the one that I went into 6 years ago at UW-La Crosse. And there were some challenges. People were dispirited, a little disheartened. And I think that an approach that we took up there that I think will work here is that you want to show people incremental progress. You want to be able to say, we're going to do something, and then you do it. And then you say, we're going to do something else, and then you do it. And over time, the wheel starts to turn. And then eventually, you start to pick up momentum. People start to believe. People start to understand that this is going to get better. And so, yes, this is a long-term project. It's a long-term commitment from me. And it is going to take some time to get to the place that we want it to be. But that doesn't mean that it's going to take a long time for us to get started and for us to start seeing some of those improvements, some of that growth, some of that cultural change in terms of the positivity and the energy and the enthusiasm around our program. And so I think we need to set up plans, and we need to start to deliver on these incremental changes that we hope people will be excited about and show some level of commitment that ultimately will resonate with them and start to generate this momentum that I'm talking about.
Josh, Jim Cotter, Danville Commercial News. You being a former football guy, does that help in any way to know that you're coming in, you know, the football program the way it's been and the way you want to do your vision for it? Does that help in any way?
I hope so. And Coach Cubitt and I will sit down and talk. And certainly I've been around football at the highest levels. I've had a chance to be around some of the best coaches in the world, Mike Holmgren's of the world, and Mike Riley and Paul Crist were both coaches of mine who are now, of course, coaches in the Big Ten. And so I think I have a good understanding of football and certainly the importance that it plays to an athletic program and to a university. But what I will not do is interject myself in a way that's not my role. I believe very much in, if you will, staying in my lane. And, you know, we all have jobs here. We all have roles to play. And mine is not to be the football coach. You know, my job is to support our football staff. My job is to ask the right questions, to get the right people in the room to provide good answers, and then ideally recognize what the best ideas are. But at the end of the day, we all recognize and understand the importance of our football program. Excited to be a contributor to that effort. But it's Coach Cuban's team, and look forward to supporting him in every way I can.
Hey, Josh, Scott Ritchie from the News Gazette. In the Chancellor's opening statement, you know, the phrase, you know, walks on water was used. Do you feel any pressure that maybe a lot of Illinois fans see you as, you know, the savior of Illinois athletics?
Well, when you put it that way, look, I'm not the savior of Illinois athletics. I don't walk on water. I'm one piece of a very big and very committed group of people. And, you know, if I can provide a spark, if I can provide some enthusiasm, if I can provide some vision and some leadership and some other things that our group here is so thirsty for, then great. And I think that's what we need. But this isn't about me. You know, I don't pretend to have all the answers. I'm not the smartest guy in any room. I think a strength of mine is to get the right people in a room, to ask the right questions, and then to identify the best ideas, which almost inevitably don't come from me. And I think that's our task here. We have a lot of unbelievably talented people, incredibly intelligent, smart, motivated, creative. We need to harness that power. We need to figure out a way to align that power with our goals. And if I can bring some structure to that, then I think I will have done a good job. Certainly, this isn't about me. It's not about me being some savior. That's not going to happen.
Sure. Josh, Matt with WAND again. There are some people, and maybe even right now on the radio, talking about your experience and probably trying to figure out the difference between Division III and Division I athletics. What's the difference to you, or is there a difference?
There are a lot more similarities than differences. At the core of what we do is our students. That will always be true. At a place like Washington University, we're able to recruit across the country the same as we do at Illinois. We're able to compete for conference and national championships. I travel all over the country and meet with an incredibly affluent and successful group of alumni, donors. There are a lot of similarities. There are some differences. You know, we don't take a lot of charter planes down in St. Louis. A lot of Division III programs are taking buses. We're at least getting to an airport and flying to some great cities. There are a few more zeros on the balance sheet. The scholarship piece is different. You know, there is a level of purity, I guess, in Division III because those student athletes don't have the financial incentive to continue playing. They truly do it because it's something they love to do. Here, I think what's wonderful about Division I is the scholarship. You know, that's something that can change someone's life. We talk about the life-changing opportunity that is the Illinois Athletic Program. Think about the power of a scholarship. Think about the opportunity that gives some student who might not have otherwise had it. And I'll tell you a quick story. I was a freshman in high school, and I was pretty young, and I set the first goal that I can ever remember setting in my life. And that goal was that my parents would not have to pay for me to go to college. They were happy about that. And from that day forward, I set about trying to figure out the best way to make that happen. And for me, it was a question of work. It was a question of focus. And the chance that I had to come to the University of Illinois and to receive a scholarship was just an incredible, incredible privilege and a life-changing opportunity. And we give that opportunity to hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of student athletes every year. And that to me is the essence of what we do. And so are there differences? Yes. Some might say better, some might say worse. But we are able to do something here that you cannot do any other place. And we're able to change someone's life through the value of the scholarship. And that to me, I felt that. I know what that is. And look forward to continuing to provide that to our athletes.
A nuts and bolts question for you, Chancellor. What are the details of Josh's compensation package?
His compensation package? We're still working out some of the details, but I can tell you that his salary is $600,000 a year. He has a five-year contract, and he has the capacity to earn bonuses on top of the base salary for academic and athletic success. Yeah. Yes.
That's a difference between Division III and Division I. They don't typically ask about your salary with your boss in front of the media. That was different.
You forgot to mention that your office is bigger here. It's
quite an office. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. Any other questions?
All right. Thank you. Okay, Josh. Yeah, we'll do that. Thank you, Chancellor.
Thank you all.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you for being here. Let's take a picture. No.